Psalm 119, verse 105 says this: "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." I recall serving in a school in the Lake District in Cumbria, and some teachers were a part of the mountain rescue team. They would help people who were lost or injured in the fells. And the leader of that team indicated that people often get hurt, not only if they're unprepared for weather and so forth, but in darkness, they cannot see where they're going, and they often fall off a ridge. And so the prudent thing when you cannot see is to wait, not to act, and to proceed with extreme caution. Anyway, the in-between of life, that phrase again from the scriptures, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." What that tells you actually is that God's word, that's thy word, God's word tells us what to do in the immediate. Very often we know instinctively, at the level of our conscience, how to act, how to do what we need to do today. We have something which cannot be undone by circumstances. What is written about by the Apostle Peter as an inheritance which can never perish, spoil, or fade, kept in heaven for you. That is, the very long distance is life with God forever. But what about the middle distance? What about the events of our life in the coming months or years? That's a part we may not know about. So thy word is a lamp unto my feet, enough to take the next step I need to take, and a light to my path. It shows me the long distance aim of where my life is going. But the middle distance, what I do for the next few months or the next few years, can be shrouded and dark or foggy. Well, Scripture tells us what honors God, and it gives us general rules that are shared, not only in Christianity, but in other ethical systems and religions. For example, the golden rule, "Do unto others what you would have them do unto you." But the framework for that actually is something much bigger. Jesus was asked a question, "Teacher, what is the greatest commandment?" And he said, "The first and greatest commandment is this: love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and with all your strength." And then he went on to say, "And the second commandment is like it: love your neighbor as yourself." And he went to say, "On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets," meaning the framework of all that is right is given by those two commandments: love God and love people. Well, what are you to do today? Well, you're to obey those two great commandments, to love God and love your neighbor. Part of loving God is living under authority, and your parents have placed you in this school so that you can learn, and they set you under the authority of your teacher. So make the most of every lesson. Take the most from each opportunity. If you're a friend, and of course all of us have friends, but we're separated from them today. If you're a friend, you can be a friend and love your neighbor. Be a friend to them. That might impact the sort of messages you send to them, to be encouraging rather than to tear them down. What about the next few months or the next few years? Well, it is the case that when things happen in life that can seem very difficult or unpleasant, when we look back on them, when we sort of cross through the valley and get up to the top, we can look down and be grateful for all the meandering turns that have been taken. It doesn't mean that each of those things was good, but God very often brings wonderful things that are unexpected out of difficult or even tragic circumstances. He did that chiefly in the death of his son on the cross, a wicked act undertaken by wicked men to put an innocent man to death. And yet that was God's appointed means to bring about the salvation of the world. God is in the business of bringing good from tragedy. "So in everything give thanks," the Apostle Paul wrote, "for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you." And how can we give thanks? By trusting that God is at work. We know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. I don't know what this day holds for you, what difficulties you are facing, what suffering you might be enduring, but I know that God's word is true, and you can commit yourself to learn more about him and how to live for him and love him. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I hope you have a very good day ahead.